Hello everyone, welcome to this the new Tech Talks what we are hosting as a part of our Rail Lab initiative. So as a first part of it, we are going to be having a lot more of this. As a first part of it, I'm going to be talking about how you could make more power. So how do you make more power out of your car or bike? So I'm going to be very generic in the first topic, and then moving forward we'll try to make it more technical and a lot more interesting. So let's just see like how an engine is making power at a very basic level. Okay, so you have an air filter through which air is going to enter into the engine, and this air travels into the engine through your throttle body. So you have the throttle body here, then you have a planer, then you have some camshaft which is sitting over here, and it enters into the engine. And as the air is entering into the engine, you also have some fuel which goes into it and a spark which is being given into the engine. So once the combustion process is over, the whole exhaust gases, the burnt mixture, it is coming out, and you would probably have a catalytic converter and a muffler here, and the air is kind of escaping, the burnt mixture is escaping out into the atmosphere. So now the whole thing, I can write it as an equation here. I can say what's happening inside the engine is basically air is mixing with fuel, it is burning and it is making me power. Now this air and fuel burning, they can only burn in a fixed ratio, something like 12:1. Okay, which means 12 parts of air needs to burn with one part of fuel. So what this means is that you cannot just take some 1 liter of petrol, put it into the engine, burn it and hope you will make more power. You cannot do that. So you can only put how much ever fuel you can corresponding to the amount of air which is going inside. Now fuel per se for us is not a limited quantity. Fuel is available inside our fuel tank in sufficient quantities. We have a fuel injector which we control using a standalone ECU, or we can change the fuel injection quantity using one of our remaps or something. So basically the fuel and spark, both those, so spark is here. Okay, so spark and fuel, this is not limited. Okay, you can kind of like go in for how much of fuel you want. It is not kind of limited. Technically speaking, it is, but still, for this assumption, let's take fuel is not limited. So what is limited then? What is limited for us is the amount of air which can flow into an engine is kind of limited. So if more amount of air can flow into the engine, you can correspondingly put more fuel and make more power. Okay, so very simply, this is all that matters. If you can flow more air into the engine, okay, your ECU can correspondingly put more fuel, and if correspondingly more fuel is there, you will make more power. Very simple. If you want to make more power, flow more air, and then make sure your ECU is putting more fuel into it. So now, how do you flow more air into the engine? Coming back here, let's see the path which the air is traveling. So the first point of contact for air is your air filter, which is here. Then it comes in here, it meets the throttle body. Okay, and of course there are going to be pipes here, but let's just like leave that out. And finally you have the camshaft, which is here. Now in order of decreasing importance, okay, so air filter is the lowest importance parameter here. Why? Because air filter is just filtering air, it is not controlling the amount of air which is going in. That is, provided you don't have a very restrictive air filter will not make much change in deciding how much of air is flowing into the engine. Throttle body will, to a certain extent, depending on how big it is, how small it is it too small, is it too large, it will. The most important parameter in defining that will be the camshaft. Not just the camshaft, but camshaft along with your valve sizes, what size of a valve you have, what is the port size and shape. So if you want to flow the most amount of air, okay, then for a naturally aspirated engine, this is what is going to give you the maximum increase in the amount of air which can flow. Of course, why do you want to increase air? Because if you increase air, then you can correspondingly increase fuel and make more power. So this is what is going to give you the maximum amount of increase. Now you say, okay, what if I didn't want to do that? What if you think you want even more power? Then what you do is, you don't depend on the engine to suck air here. So here basically air is being sucked inside by the engine. Okay, so you don't wait for the engine to suck in air. What you do is you go ahead and you install a turbocharger. So now when you install a turbocharger, what ends up happening is that the turbocharger is going to blow air into your engine versus suck. So the difference is that if you had a 100cc engine, let's assume this is a 100cc engine. So if you're going to let the air come into the engine all by itself, as in if the engine has to suck it, then let me say naturally aspirated, which is engine is sucking air, then it can probably only fill 85cc of air. It cannot fill more than that. Okay. Whereas if it is forced induction, FI, or if it is blow, then depending on the size of turbo, the boost pressure I'm running, I can fill in 100cc, or I can fill in 200cc, or even 300cc of air. Now what you see here is very simply, if you have a turbocharger on an engine, you can take a 100cc engine and make it flow as much air as a 300cc engine. If you are flowing air corresponding to 300cc, then corresponding to that you can put in fuel, and corresponding to that you will get more power. So the idea for you to understand here is that ultimately, if you want your engine to make more power, you have to flow more air through the engine.